the master of the dugout and the media now on Channel 442, as we salute the genius that was Brian Clough.
Helping build a better home for your team. ESPN Classic Football, proudly sponsored by C&A Building Plastics. C&A, top of their league. For home improvements.
Liverpool winners of two FA Cups and three championships. Leeds, one cup and two championships. And in fact, each has had a team in the final for all the FA Cup finals of the 70s. Either Leeds or Liverpool has been here at Wembley. There on his right, the man who takes over from Don Revie, Brian Clough, who has won championship to his credit with Derby County. Brian Clough starting, I suppose, at the top. Not a bad way to open your account with your new team at Wembley. Billy Bremner with the championship trophy. Emlyn Hughes with the FA Cup. And Brian Clough there, you notice, applauding Bill Shankly. It's Shankly's moment, and Brian Clough well aware of that fact. Wearing number 12. Man who mesmerised Chelsea in the 1970 Cup final. Paul Madeley got a knock against Villa in midweek and so is out of the side. Otherwise, the first choice side that won the championship. The Liverpool team, which includes also an interesting number 12, Phil Borsma. Otherwise, it's their first choice side. Phil Borsma, an interesting choice, but he was the man who walked out when he was left out of the FA Cup final team, wasn't chosen as substitute. Bob Matheson, former professional footballer, comes from Bolton. Among the substitutes, the biggest transfer of the season, Duncan McKenzie, of the close season rather. And it's a sunshine start to the new season. First free kick to Liverpool. James Jordan. Cherry. Incidentally, 10 yards narrower than usual. Tommy Smith's tackle that quite rightly gets the booking. Tommy Smith, the first statistic of the Charity Shield match. Ten minutes of the first half gone. Number 10, Giles with the free kick. And a bit of pushing by Jordan. I was saying before that tackle that the pitch this afternoon is 10 yards narrower than usual. That's because of the speedway track, it's 5 yards narrow on each side. And it would be for the FA Cup final or international match. It's too much pace. Paul Callaghan. Highway. Thank you. Thompson. Boos, of course, coming to the Leeds end for Smith. Cormack saw that all the way and then took his eye off it when it arrived. Here's Hall. Highway. Oh, Hunter. Not a good tackle by any stretch of the imagination. Good header by McQueen. Corner. Bill Thompson coming up, number four. Clark almost deflecting that past Harvey as he came out. By Gray, Greeny outside Lorimer, Clark and Jordan in the middle. Gray, good blocking by Smith, and a very positive challenge that was by Joe Jordan. Beautifully off the outside of his boots. Lorimer being forced wide. Greeny again on the overlap. Using two minds, but recovered his footing. It's good flowing stuff in the sunshine. Here's Bosma. Keegan behind him, Highway in the middle. Here's Keegan. Clearly attempting to nick it in by the near post. Eddie Gray. Another good header by Cormack. Bremner. Hughes is a bit short. Thompson. Cormack. Keegan now out on the left. Crack on for him at the moment. Now Cormack coming up. But he wasn't balanced. But at least he saw that Keegan needed help. Brian Clough and Bill Shankly next door to each other. Liverpool in the front row and Leeds behind them. Free kick to Liverpool for a push. Keegan, good save. But it's going to go in and it's gone. Well, he was unlucky, David Harvey. He made a very good save from Keegan. And I must say that goal, very, very reminiscent of the goal by which Liverpool beat Leeds at Anfield in March of last season. Who will actually get the credit? Well, frankly, at this moment, your guess is as good as mine. It ricocheted around, it was Keegan's shot, and it may well have flicked off Bill Borsma. But a goal out of nothing, just bouncing well for Liverpool and unkindly for Leeds when David Harvey made a very good save. Bit of money that Don Revie at this moment is remembering that goal last March. Oh, beautifully played, Keegan. Got to hit it now. Well, there's a chance on here and it's blocked. Borsma's shot. Post. Borsma with the back header. Oh, that struck so well. According to the scoreboard, the scorer was Phil Borsma. They were in a far better position to see than I was. There he is. Be nice for him as he missed the final in May. Hunter. Leeds not quite themselves since that goal. Bad sort of goal to concede. Cormack. Jordan on his own, now has Gray out to the left. Did very well then, Joe Jordan. Bremner, Lorimer, through the gap nicely. Clark unlucky, appealing for handball, but never was. McQueen coming forward. And Leeds second corner of the match. For which McQueen stays up, just at the bottom of the picture there, with a fair hair, number five. But too high for him. Leeds have got three back. Rini now making it four. Keegan. Highway in the middle, marked by Cherry. Hughes. Robert Jordan now behind the ball for Leeds. Lindsay. Superb stop from Brian Hall and a good save by David Harvey. Good tackle by Lorimer. Really a very good throw out then by David Harvey. Giles. Bremner, interesting. Jordan to his left, Clark further over. Good lead by Clements, but I think that Bremner's colleagues will feel that he could have used that to either of them. Clark certainly was wide and in space. Now Borsma for Liverpool. Highway. Good save. Timed it superbly. But there are times where this Leeds defence is looking a little bit short of pace. Giles. Jordan couldn't make it because Clements got there first. Keegan. Borsmer is to his right, number 12. Hall, number 8. Good early cross. Greeny's header and a good one. Cormack. Callaghan. Here's Borsma. Season. Eddie Gray. Edmund Hughes, another thunderous effort, reminiscent of the one against Arsenal and the one against Ipswich last season. Callaghan. Giles. Bremner finding Giles again. Greeny. Four to find, here's Clark! And his face summarises that. From Rooney's cross, Alan Clark all alone. Giles, he got a verbal rebuke then from Bob Matheson. Shield match 1-0 to Liverpool, with Phil Borsma being credited with the goal, the final touch after David Harvey had saved from Kevin Keegan, a goal in many ways out of nothing, contrasting with a tremendous shot by Evan Hughes which came back off the crossbar. Liverpool though deserving their 1-0 lead at half time, and Leeds United at times looking a little bit lacking in pace in defence. Bill Shankly looking rather serious as he comes out for the second half. And as he does so, Don Revie takes his seat in the royal box. And Brian Clough, who's had to do the job that Don Revie did so well for so long. The half-time dressing room chat goes back to his seat with his trainer, Jimmy Gordon. Cross was with him at Derby County. Liverpool now playing into the wind and the sun, and no team changes by either side. Keegan being forced away by McQueen. Gray. Cherry. Lorimer. Giles. Gray. Good try. Lorimer both out to the right. Here's Reaney. Now Lorimer, number seven. Liverpool still leaving three players forward. Lorimer, good cross. And Jordan, a little unlucky in the challenge with Smith. But a very good cross by Peter Lorimer, hit very early. Fall. A bit short, but he took it well. Clark is up forward, looking for Jordan instead. It's a bit long, but it'll run for him. Bremner. Went one way, tried to come back the other. Jordan unable to bore in on that pass. Just forced him more to the corner than perhaps he would have liked. And Hunter coming forward. Oh, well done. Clark is down hurt. Borsma coming away. Cormack who made that challenge on Hunter. Well, no one was there, and that's where they ought to have been. Fields, an attacker. Anna Clark still down. Borsma, nicely done. Good save. Can try again. Really, if he'd have kept his head then, he wouldn't have gone for the second shot, I feel. He could have found Cormack. And then Harvey would have been committed in the wrong spot. But the pressure's still on. Just looking handball, but I think it hit hand rather than the other way. And that looked very much like a right hook by Johnny Giles. Keegan, the player, down. But up rather quickly. What a decision for Bob Mathewson at the start of the season. Well, the name certainly going into the book. And that's all. quite frankly, if the referee saw that as a bookable offence, and if it was the hook that it looked, then I don't quite understand why it's only a name take. Meantime, Alan Clark in a sort of halfway position and going off. Free kick never on, and as that ball goes past, the figure all in white is Duncan McKenzie. And now what? More trouble off the ball. Keegan involved again, and this is just what English football did not want to see. Surely we've got to get away from this. Keegan involved again. Better view of that than I did. Billy Bremner being called over. McQueen being waved away. Meanwhile, Alan Clark limps off, looking a rather sad figure. And Kevin Keegan having words with the referee. It rather looks as though the referee has taken stronger action this time. Keegan, who was sent off in Germany when it was a case of mistaken identity, and he's off here. And he's absolutely livid about it. And my feeling is that Johnny Giles should have gone in the first place, and there might then not have been a second case. Fifteen minutes of the second half, and Kevin Keegan, who a few moments ago seemed to be commiserating with Johnny Giles, and Bremner is off as well. Bremner is off as well. They're both throwing their shirts down, and really this is a side of English football, a face of English football we do not want to see. What do the players think they are doing? To dismiss the referee's authority in such a manner cannot be good for the game. However they feel, he is the judge, and his judgment has to stand. And now we've got a fan on the field, and we are seeing the unacceptable face of English football. And in the midst of that placard, Duncan McKenzie gets on the field as a Leeds player for the first time. Gray. Played by Cherry. Giles is coming onto it. Jordan came in a little bit too soon. Ready, calm. Jordan went in on it and it seemed to go loose. And in comes McQueen, for what reason I can't imagine. And this is what's wrong with the play. It's all right a player making a genuine challenge, but when others get involved in situations that have nothing to do with them, that's when the real trouble comes. Lindsay. Just right of the penalty spot, Hall further over, goal kick. Bill Bosma then looking like Kevin Keegan. Sort of run that we associate with Kevin Keegan. Peter Cormack, the player hurt. Lima. Cherry! Oh, he took up such a good position. That was a lovely goal. We've come back to some football. The players have been trying to pick the game up after it appeared to have been killed stone dead. And Trevor Cherry was looking for that so well. From Lorimer's cross, got the nick in to give Clements no chance. ...70 minutes of the match gone, 1-1 the score, 10 men playing 10 men. Giles de Grey, Cherry. Reaney. Giles, Reaney going down that flank. Grey. He was the player who nearly forced it in. Goal kick, but pushing anyway, so a free kick has been given. Done well, and the point being shown by the linesman, outside. So Hall's going to take the free kick, Highway up on one side, Borsman number 12 there we just looked at on the other, now coming across. And leaving no one to come into the gap until Callaghan arrives. Lovely start. Superb by Callaghan. And Cormack so near. Goal kick. But there's the example. There is a real player who's given an example to schoolboys, which I hope will make them forget what they saw earlier. Good cross again, and McKenzie's header over. Hasn't made a bad start. Cormack. Thompson. Smith. Highway. Shot, he really hit that, and Harvey did very well. Tremendous piece of play by Highway, both the drag and pulling the ball away from his opponent, and then the shot. Hunter, Loma. Greeny. Giles! Looked as though he was going to trap it. Just moved the knee a little bit forward and instead flicked directly at it. Would have made a picture goal. Smith. Phil Thompson. I must say that the 10 remaining men on each side have kept the pace going remarkably well for an opening match at home this season. Here's Hall. Greeny. The touch was enough. A number of players with socks around ankles. Oh, well, great Lindsay. Bosma, look at the endeavour there. Highway, tackled by Giles. It really has been such a good match. That's why the sendings off are so tragic. Or at least it adds to that tragedy. It'd be tragic anyway. But really, it's not so much that the players went, but the way in which they went. And a penalty competition it's going to be. One-one, the final scoreline over the 90 minutes. Bosma number 12 there, the scorer for Liverpool. And Trevor Cherry getting the equaliser for Leeds United. So it's now up to Ray Clements and David Harvey. And the competition going to take place in the goal to our right at the end of the players' tunnel. Linesman already in position to check that the goalkeeper doesn't move. Bob Mathewson coming up, and alongside him, Peter Lima. So, Peter Lima against Ray Clements. One nothing to Leeds United. Alec Lindsay now against David Harvey. One apiece. Johnny Giles and a lot of whistles for him. Yeah. 2-1 to Leeds. Emery News. Now to try his luck against David Harvey. Well, we're seeing a number of different types of penalties. That was the blaster. Before that, we saw Johnny Giles place it. Two apiece. Eddie Gray, the next to go. Three, two. But it can't be taken. A kick of very different style to that of Emlyn Hughes. Brian Hall, the job of making it 3-3. Which he does very comfortably. The penalty kicking so far of a very high standard. Brian Clough smiling, the two goalkeepers exchanging pleasantries. And Mr. Back to Legs himself, Norman Hunter. Four, three. Now Norman Hunter, who played here in 1965 in the cup final, being followed by another player who did so on the opposite side, of course, Tommy Smith. Four apiece. So Trevor Cherry coming up for the last of Leeds' five penalties. If there's no verdict, then we go into sudden death. Once the side is established in front, that's it. But if Cherry was to miss this, Liverpool would still have to take number five. Spot making the ball look a little bit flat, but it's not, although it's been hammered a fair bit in this friendly competition. Clements not too far away from that. 5-4. The goalkeepers might be wondering whether they'll end up taking penalties against each other. Peter Cormack with Liverpool's number 5. In all possible senses, wearing number 5 shirt, taking their 5th penalty to take us into sudden death. But at this rate, we could be here all night. The goalkeeper's looking to see who comes next. And they have a special union, of course. Oh, it looks as though Harvey is going to take against Clements. Well, there was a Charity Shield match in which Pat Jennings scored against Alex Stepney, but that was in the normal 90 minutes and from a goal kick. On a clearance. But Clements still has to take his. That's not it. What a lovely picture. And in fact, Callaghan is coming up to take. So Clements not being given the responsibility. So Ian Callaghan, the footballer of the year, with the chance to give Liverpool the Charity Shield. Which he does. Bill Shankly congratulating Bob Paisley first. The players congratulating Callaghan. So the cup winners beat the league champions, and the last time that happened was in 1962 when Spurs beat Ipswich, and those two have met many times before, Emlyn Hughes and Bill Shankly. And except for the most staunch Leeds United supporters, I think there will be a certain feeling that it's nice for Bill Shankly to have won the last time he was here. So Emlyn Hughes comes up to collect the Charity Shield from the former president of FIFA, Sir Stanley Rouse. Hat on again. There were plenty of those going around at Wembley last May. Well, a happy end. Sir Stanley Rouse there. Ted Croker, Mr. Smith, the chairman of Liverpool Football Club. T.B. Williams, the president. Mr. Cross, also on the board. Bill Boisma, consolation for him for missing the final. Alec Lindsay, Peter Cormack, Ray Clements. So Liverpool prepared to go on yet another lap of honour. and Bill Shankly will go with them if his supporters will let him do so. Peter Cormack, who really had a very fine game indeed. Everybody wants to get round Bill Shankly. So Bill Shankly breaks into a jog trot to take away the last trophy that Liverpool can win under his managership. Takes the charity shield into the dressing room. One in a friendly competition after the score at the end of 90 minutes was 1-1.
Helping build a better home for your team. ESPN Classic Football, proudly sponsored by C&A Building Plastics. C&A. Top of their league. For home.